All right, guys, we're back. I've got the wings completed. Everything's in them. I've taken all my leads for my servo runs coming out. We've got four hookups here. Ailerons for me, main flaps, the little flaps, which is for that servo there, and green is for gear. Very simplistic in my mind's eye. Each one of those, of course, corresponds to a channel on the receiver. What I've done now thus far already is I've got these two dowels. Those two dowels are found with a template that they supply with the rig. I'll show you that here just a second. And I've drilled those holes that the template showed and stuck in some dowel. Those are dowels that just basically for shear and alignment for the wing to the fuse every time you put it on. This is a little quarter 20. Blind nut back in the backside there that they've put in that was already came that way. So you just use a quarter 20. I use a socket head bolt, Allen head bolt for that. So it pulls it in real easy and real nice. So you do the same thing on the fuselage. Use your the aluminum spar for your alignment, and you just slide your template onto it. And drill your holes. Make sure your angles are correct. The wing makes up with a little bit of dihedral, and it looks like it's supposed to be square, but it isn't. It's got to be a little bit off, and you'll figure that out when you get into it. It's a real simple process. You're going to do it twice, of course, one for each side. You know, the template comes off. There's the holes that I've made. And I'm going to have to punch another hole right up, right about here. I haven't done that yet. That'll be for the servos. So, or the servo wires, that is. What I've moved on to here now is I've got inside the fuse, you can see I've got two pull wires set through, which is for the elevator control. The elevator control itself needs to be put in before you make up your two horizontal stabs. You got to have that, otherwise you can't get them in, and you'll have a hell of a time. That's just part of the process. I've already mounted the tail wheel assembly. Pretty simple. The little black tubes that the pull wires come through, you need to break those off pretty much flush to that little I'm gonna call it firewall, but it's that frame wall there to make up your cables to the pull for this tail wheel. For this turn for tail wheel. Now inside, I've got a couple pieces of little bamboo dowel there just to hold the face of the surface that I'm going to be gluing against for the elevator, or I should say the horizontal stab. I've just done a little bit of effort on it to get her straight, and you know, I'm putting a straight edge on it on the face on both edges, and both edges here just to get it ready for the epoxy. What I've done is I've taken my Dremel and I've cleaned off all the paint and got me down to bare material, fiberglass, to give the epoxy something to bite to. That is absolutely need to do that, otherwise you're kind of risking your joint. Here's the elevator end, pretty simple, right? Horizontal stab in, sorry, and sanded it and cleaned it up. This hole here is for the aluminum stab that goes through it. That'll go right through the plane as well. When we get this set up, I'm going to mix up some glue. 30-minute epoxy, slow cure. A little warm out today. We're only 105. Not too bad, but you know, I can handle that. But don't get in a hurry with your epoxy. I mean, that's a I've learned the hard way. Okay, you want to get done real quick. Well, 15 minutes, I whizzed through it, but really and truly, for these type of connections, whether it be a wing to, you know, your wing makeup or your horizontal stab to the fuse or whatever, you know, try to take some time with it and don't get in a rush and use a fast epoxy. For one thing, it's not as good, and for two, it just, you get in a hurry and you don't get her right where she needs to be, kind of hooched. I just use 10 snips to cut wood, It's very simple, and it makes life a lot easier sometimes, so you don't have to cut it with a knife or whatever. If it's just for braces or whatever, you know, it's just simple to use. My tools, there's just two different types of sticks right now for my epoxy. I'll mix with these and I'll use these as well for long reaches. Damn, I gotta keep the camera down there where it belongs, sorry. And these guys are just for a little fine work. I do have brushes when I need to brush a big surface, but this is a pretty simple one. But what I'll do is when I'll glue this up, I'll load up the spar and stick it in and glue it in at the same time. This will all be one glue job, clear through the fuselage. I'll get it lined up and I'll sit there and babysit it for 15, 20 minutes until the epoxy really starts to set up, and get it nice and clean, and then just leave it alone for half an hour to an hour, and she'll be cured enough to where she can be worked with again later on. So make sure that your fabric or your coating here has been nice liner down, because you don't want to pull out in the future. Sand it. I sand it with about 100 grit sandpaper, which makes it easy to do. So right now I'm going to just get set up. I got my alcohol there, right there. She blows. Just good old 91 wood grain alcohol, that is. And I use that to, of course, to cut the epoxy and clean it as I'm going. Just have everything all ready out there, and before you mix up your first dose of epoxy, try to make enough. Don't be shy. Don't be stingy with epoxy. It's cheap. It's your best friend. So make up enough to do the whole job at one time. So I'm going to make up some stuff here, and I'll glue it up, and I'll show you what it looks like when we're all said and done. All right, thanks.